श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। आंगिकं भुवनं यस्य वाचिकं सर्ववाग्भयं आहार्यं चंद्रताराभितं वंदे सात्विकं शुभम्। I am Vidushi Dr. Swati P. Bharadwaj, took a new initiative as making a videos in the title Theory of Bharatanatyam to spread the knowledge of Bharatanatyam's theory as per my learned knowledge and some book references. In last episode, we learned Bharatanatyam and its greatness. So in today's session, we are going to know about the fundamental technical terms of Bharatanatyam. According to Natyashastra treatise, the art of classical dance is divided into the three broad divisions, Nritta, Nritya, and Natya. We'll discuss one by one now. In Natya, along with the use of the spoken word, the expressions, mime, and actions or gestures of Abhinaya, dance and movements and the elements of drama are involved. Nritta is a pure dance with no specific theme, containing adhus, rhythm patterns, poses, and adhu jatis. Example, jatiswaram, tilana, alaripu, etc. Natya is a dance composition with both abhinaya and nritta. Shabdam, padam, varnam are the examples for that. So what is abhinaya now? Abhinaya is a Sanskrit word, the prefix abhi meaning towards and naya meaning to lead. It therefore means that it leads or to convey an idea, an emotion or an event to the audience. The thoughts of the mind when shows or expressed by actions with the uses of fingers, etc. are called as abhinaya. So abhinaya has four aspects like angika, the gestures of limbs, Vachika, verbal display, Aharya, representation through makeup, Satvika, temperamental or conceptual. So we will go to the depth of Abhinaya in the next upcoming episodes. So now, what is Adugu? It is a fundamental dance unit used in Nritta, or the pure form of dance without Abhinaya, where hands, feet, head, eyes and other parts of the body move in a coordinated manner. The word adhu is said to have been derived from the Tamil root adu, means to dance. So what is korvai? A combination of the adhus within the rhythmic limit and danced into an aesthetically beautiful sequence is called as korvai. Korvai can be owned to swara patterns or solkattu set to a tala. It always ends with the makutadu, usually repeated in multiples of three. What is jati? A group of korvais along with the solkattu of a guru or natuvanar is collectively referred to as jati. So what is tirmanam? It refers to the korvai ending with makutadavus and jatis with mridangam solkattus. This occurs either at the end of a song or a dance or in between song sequences. These are called makuta adhus because they are mostly done thrice or in multiples of three. Beautify dance sequences by giving them a crowning effect. So then what is solkattu? Solkattu is also known as rhythmic syllables, referred to the mridangam words used in dance. Example, the tattakara words like taiha taihi, tayum tattat, etc. are used in dance classes. When these adhus combine to form a jati on stage, they assume a sweet pronunciation of mridangam solkattus like jamtari, takanaka, kirdakadaribidadom. So these all. So what is natuangam? The instrument played by the guru or teacher is called natuangam. The cymbal that is held in one hand is bigger and made of iron, while the one that is used to strike is smaller and made of heavier bronze and also called as panchalukha. Playing the cymbal helps to guide the feet of the dancer in other time. Playing the cymbals and thus conducting the whole dance is known as natuangam. There are two aspects involved in playing the cymbals. Vallinam, that means strong. Mellinam, that means gentle. So I hope it's worthy making a video as Theory of Bharatanatyam episode 2. If you have any of the doubts about today's episode, you can contact us. The contact details will be on description. So please, if you like this video, like, comment and share as much as possible to spread the art theory of Bharatanatyam. So please subscribe to my YouTube channel also and press bell icon for continuous updates. Thank you. Hari Om.